We're very excited to be welcoming back to the stage one of our favorite banjo players in the whole world, and we're lucky to have her as a local. She lives just down the road. Ladies and gentlemen, please give it up for the Gina Furtado Project.
Thank you. soundman Eric. Can we get less banjo in the monitors, please? And I believe we have other requests.
Oh, can I please have some more guitar and the bass player? The five.
Thank you.
gonna try one that I did not write, but I really like it since I am a mother, and this one is probably the only like kind of traditional sounding bluegrass song that I've ever heard that's written from the perspective of a mother. And it is written by a woman in Dallas, Gerard, and she sang a duet with Hazel Dickens, and it's just really nice, spoke to me, so I decided I wanted to sing it too. This one's called Mama's Gonna Stay. In the early morning light, I creep on down the stairs. Hush, you floor, keep the squeaking down. Oh, the smell of good hot coffee and the silence all around. And nothing but my thoughts and stirring up the sound can break the sad, sweet feeling, Lord, of being alone. Now if I'm very still, I can drain this holy out. And if I'm lucky, stretch it out to two. Smiles and tears and ratty hair, and I can't find my shoe. And I don't know, Lord, I don't know if I can make it. But I hope you know how much I love you. Cause I guess it ain't showing much these days. Just don't. But anyway, I guess I'm gonna instruments. I just got this new strap that goes over both shoulders for all the people who know how heavy banjos are. And this is the first gig I've played with these guys with this new strap, and I took it out of my case all proudly, and Malia said, well, I don't know, it looks a little geriatric. So now I'm all self-conscious.
The new tattoo adds to the youthful vibe.
Right. I know, I had to combat the dorky strap. Well, over here on the left, we've got this fantastic guitar player. And you know, Corey, I asked you to send me a bio like 2 weeks ago. It never came, so there's only one thing I can say about Corey, is that he has a really fat cat that everybody loves. So please make him welcome on the guitar. Corey Wells, Richmond, Virginia. Charlottesville area. So so it just really struck a chord with me, and I decided to write this tune. And as it turns out, somebody must have played it on the radio, and somebody else heard it on the radio and sent me an email and said, is that about the Battle of Sanders Creek? Because I own that farm where that took place. And also, his grandfather, or his great-grandfather, fought in that battle. Pretty so, close your eyes and imagine yourself Battle of Sanders Creek. Enjoying the fruits of my labor, because I had to witness the development of a young fiddle player, beginning when she was 3 years old. And I really want you to show them the vibrato practice sounded exactly like a giant mosquito, but she said she's not in the mood to demonstrate. Well, she is the director of education at the Front Porch in Charlottesville, which is a great music school. And can be found also playing with a number of different bands. You're playing with Only Lonesome Tomorrow and High and Wise, which they've come here a couple times. They're fantastic. Okay, we're gonna try another one that is gonna be up on my upcoming album here this summer. I like to write songs that are kind of based in some reality, and this one is no exception. It's about the time I got stood up on a date, and you'll hear what happened next. It's called Take Your Time, I'll Be Fine. Still you are there. You're just caught up in the other things. I wrote. It's about the lessons we can learn from nature. And it goes a little something like this.
Try.
that I had just picked up yesterday, a DVD, an instructional DVD, that I was featured on for the Murphy Method teaching philosophy. It's got all kinds of stuff for many different skill levels of banjo players, so if you're interested in that, I've got that, and I've got my own solo album, and this really awesome project I got to be part of for Roland White. Roland White did an album of his own recently and featured a bunch of younger artists, so I'm on there as well. So visit that table if you like, one way or the other, we'll be back to hang out and enjoy Colebrook Road. We've got a couple more for you tonight. This one is called Dusk Can Wait.
Little boy afraid he'd be exposed.
all.
Thank you.
Y'all enjoy the Gina Furtado project? Yeah!
I know I did.
Well, we're very, very excited to have these guys back on our stage. They're on an album release tour right now. So you want to make sure you go and check out their album. They've got a nice merch table set up back there. All the way from Pennsylvania, ladies and gentlemen, please make them feel very welcome to the stage, Colebrook Road.
Thank you. Well, thank you so much. We are Colebrook Brew. We came down here from Pennsylvania. We're very happy to be here on a Friday night. So folks, how about another hand for the Gina Furtado Project? Yes! Some great stuff. Take any chance we can get to collaborate with Gina. That was really cool to get to listen to that. Play a bunch of original tunes tonight. Those last two were in that same category. The first one was a title cut off our brand new record with Mountain Fever Records that is available for purchase tonight. It's called On Time. You may have heard that on the Bluegrass Junction. We found out back in March that it reached number 16 on the Bluegrass Today charts, which is pretty cool. And that second tune was written by our mandolin player. It was named after a wild scenic river down in West Virginia called the Cheat River. It's called Teardrop Falls. And this next tune is also off our new record. This is a love song that I wrote for the prettiest girl that I know. She's my niece. She lives out in Fort Wayne, Indiana. She's only 3.5 years old. This one's named after her. It's called Coralie. Last Sunday, it was a very special experience. Hoping to take the boys out there this July. It's a place called the Conowago Creek. This is just some reflections about looking up at the stars at night. We hope you like it. It's called Velvet.
inside me what I'm watching. Go scudding by and divine. General fear.
She wrote a tune on our very first album that was released way back in 2012. And this tune is it's kind of a dark ballad that he wrote, and we decided to put it on our new record. It's got some good imagery in this one, and we have like the old square neck resophonic guitar over here. The student is called Evening Rain.
Subway cars and corner bars, where they come home. Satin socks and pent-up eyes, slouched upon your throne. But your jaded smirk and faded skirt spin stories of their own, of drunken fights and endless nights on the grass you roam. Evening rain upon the gutter, same old pain upon the skin. Strange face. Evening
About trying to make a living as a farmer up north of Pennsylvania, where we come from. Kind of some reflections of my childhood. This one's called The Dry Ground Blues.
I love you.
Gina, thank you so much. That's called the Dry Ground Blues. Say it's open to interpretation with a slight nod to the great poet who has since passed on from our generation, Maya Angelou. The song is called The Caged Bird.
Stay. Share the burden equally.
too. We're gonna try an old Bela Fleck instrumental. It was on an album that he put together called Drive. And we'll do our best to drive it here.
White bar.
So this tune was called White Water. Thank you. sorry about the technical difficulties there, folks. That was a lot of fun. Thank you, Gina. We're going to take a short, well, I guess you could say breather. We'll slow things down a little bit after that. This is a song that I wrote to put on our new album. Involves a little bit of soul searching. Get the old claw hammer style banjo out for this one. This tune is called To Love Again.
Sometimes it's like a freight train running through my mind again. It whispers through the tall pines with a voice that sounds just like an old friend. It says love.
I'm gonna try a tune that covers one of the requisite topics.
Thank you. This land you call home will be gone soon. Thank you.
Eric Malone. But do we have any fans out here tonight of the great Texas songwriter named Steve Earle? Well, let's do, try one of his tunes. It's an old rock and roll song he recorded on an album back in 1997. This tune is called Hardcore Troubadour. Thank you. Well, thank you. That tune's on our new album. We'd love to send you home with one, so please come and say hello. We've got plenty of copies back there for you. We have time for just one more. I want to thank you so much for coming out tonight. Thank you to Chord Brewing. Thank you to Gina Furtado and her Gina Furtado Project. Thank you so much. We are Colebrook Road. We're from Pennsylvania. We'll be all over the country this summer, so please keep up with us. Colebrookroad.com. Follow us on all the social media things that you use. We sure appreciate playing for you folks tonight. We'll finish things up with an old Ricky Skaggs tune way up in the key of B. This one's called The One-Way Track.
Thank you.
Oh, that was great. What do you guys think? You want to hear one more song? Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for Colebrook. And give it up one more time for Gina Furtado Project. Yeah, that was super awesome. We got lots of great music coming down the line here at B-Core Brewing Company. We got Blue Miracle here tomorrow night. Those guys have been around the block, and they are fantastic.